in order for economies to grow, we need to have sustainable jobs, good quality jobs, because that's important not just for economies, but for people's well-being as well.
You need to have respect and dignity in your workplace. You need to have a certain amount of hours. You don't need to be called in within 12 hours notice and expected to work, because people have lives outside their job as well.
Not knowing what you're going to be doing week to week or day to day is a huge issue for workers in my industry. Not knowing how many hours you're going to be working during the week, not knowing if you're going to be able to make your rent, and it's as short term as that, but looking into the future is impossible. We can't think even about mortgages or planning families, because it's unrealistic when things are so precarious.
Precarious work prevents you from having a typical housing career, if you know what I mean, because people, let's say, can't afford the rent, they have to move back with their parents, they're sharing. It's not this kind of traditional moving out of home, sharing with friends, living with your partner, buying your house. And then in terms of health, there's a lot of mental health issues. People are depressed, people have anxiety attacks, panic attacks, because they're worried about the future, but they can't afford counseling, so they can't seek professional help. People are postponing a family formation, especially women.
The proportion of people with full-time permanent jobs has been decreasing over the last decade. We now have approximately 59% of people in Europe who are on full-time permanent jobs. That means that we have a significant portion of people now who are increasingly in so-called non-standard work. I think we need to be quite cautious about very absolute predictions that young people don't want long-term jobs. There are a number of large studies in the UK, the US and Australia which show that young people have significant concerns about pay and about conditions. And in fact, there's some research to show that people under the age of 30 have moved less in jobs since the recession than people over the age of 30. There's no real significant evidence that so-called millennials have any great difference of interests than older people in terms of wanting what are so-called good jobs.
Why would anybody not want to have some sort of sense of security for their future, to be able to pay rent and eventually be able to have some sort of stability within their lives? It's absolutely vital that we have some sort of sense of security and know what we're doing week to week, year to year. Getting together and discussing issues is vitally important if we want to see any improvements in our industry.